In our ongoing attempt to find the brightest employee in all of Rooster Teeth Productions, we have decided to sit down today with Mr. Gavin Free. Hello, Gavin.
Hi.
And today, Gavin, we will be discussing the topic of science. You are somewhat of an amateur scientist yourself.
I love science.
Although you are not an educated science professional, we should still listen to what you have to say today.
I think so.
Okay. You know anything about dinosaurs?
I know some things about dinosaurs.
Okay.
One of them was a lie.
How one dinosaur was lying?
Brontosaurus.
Brontosaurus. You're saying it was not an actual dinosaur.
I think what happened is a dinosaur fell on top of another one when it died.
Uh-huh.
Crushed it.
How would that happen?
A meteor.
Meteor.
Blown over on the same spot.
I mean, why wouldn't the dinosaur have two skulls and all that?
Why wouldn't it have two skulls?
I don't know. I mean, how long ago did the dinosaurs live?
But there's different chunks of dinosaur time.
Right. What's one of the chunks?
Paleozo-Cretaceous.
Paleozo-Cretaceous.
Cretaceous is its own one.
Okay.
All the entertaining dinosaurs happen in the Cretaceous period.
All the ones we make classics,
movies about. T-Rex.
Nice. That is a classic. When was the fake one, the Brontosaurus? When was that?
Jurassic.
Any other fake dinosaurs you know about?
I think they all had feathers, then evolved into today's birds, but not the T-Rex.
What did the T-Rex evolve into?
I think it just died.
Just died.
There's no bird that's that big. Ostrich, maybe.
What about a magnet? How does a magnet work?
There's push magnetic.
Right.
And pull. Well, because north wants to point north, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Why aren't there any east-west magnets?
There aren't any east-west... Well, no, now I'm thinking of a compass. See, you've confused me there.
I'm sorry.
There's nothing on the east or west of the planet because there isn't one.
There's no east and west.
There's no pole.
Okay.
There's no such thing as a eastern hemisphere.
There's no such thing as the eastern hemisphere.
No.
Why do we have on the globes then the eastern hemisphere?
Well, that's man-made.
Right.
But if you stop the Earth
uh-huh.
from spinning this way and spun it that way, it would then have an east and west pole.
Right.
Convincing everyone would be hard though.
It would be difficult.
Because everyone's so used to Antarctica.
You're obviously a smart guy. One was a brainy guy. You want to talk about the brain for a second? What are the different parts of the brain called?
You have the two hemispheres.
Real hemispheres or man-made ones?
East and west.
East and west. Okay, go ahead.
And they're connected by something that if you snip,
yep.
you go mental.
Okay.
You want to pick something up with your right hand? You can't.
And what is
because
this thing?
Because you use your left brain
right.
to do right hand. But if you cut it, you have to think of something else before you can... Because there's no... transfer of information.
You can't use your hands anymore, it sounds like.
You can, but the wrong one.
Because you cut the thing, the bit in the middle.
The cerebellum.
The cerebellum.
Or is that in the nose?
Well, I'm going to ask you a quick lightning round.
Okay.
I'm going to name a famous scientist, and you tell us what they did or what they said. Okay? Jonas Salk.
Discovered where the brain was.
Socrates.
Discovered the Earth was round.
Okay. Stephen Hawking.
Discovered space. Distant space objects.
Okay, wow. Got 100% on that. Congratulations. That was great. That was perfect. Nailed that one. All right. Well, couldn't stump him. Gavin, I want to thank you for joining us today. We learned a lot about science. We want to thank you all for joining us.